Hey everyone, this is Anam. Welcome to my YouTube channel. In this video, I'll be explaining the poem, The Tale of Custard the Dragon, along with all the poetic devices. It's from the book First Flight of Class 10 and the poet is Ogden Nash. Ogden Nash was an American poet and he was well known for his light verse. Most of his poems are humorous. This poem is a ballad. Ballad is a narrative poem. It usually tells a story, a tale, about a tale of courage, heroism. In this poem, the central character, as it is obvious from the title, the central character is a dragon. His name is Custard. The poem tells us that appearances are often deceptive. We cannot judge a person on the basis of his or her appearance. In this poem, the dragon is teased by everyone. Everyone thinks that he is a coward, he doesn't have any courage to fight, but he proves everyone wrong. Let's begin. Belinda lived in a little white house with a little black kitten and a little gray mouse, and a little yellow dog and a little red wagon, and a really truly little pet dragon. There was a girl, her name was Belinda, and she lived in her little white house, and she had many pets. She had a black kitten, she had a gray mouse, a yellow dog, and a pet dragon. She also had a red wagon. Wagon means a vehicle used for transporting goods. Really truly here means really truly. Obviously, it's a wrong spelling which has been used by the poet. This poetic device, when a writer takes the liberty to go away from the conventional rules of language, like changing spellings of certain words just to create a rhyming effect. So this literary device is called poetic license. So realio trulio means really truly. Now, the name of the little black kitten was Ink, and the little gray mouse, she called him Blink. Kitten's name was Ink, and she called the mouse Blink. And the little yellow dog was sharp as mustard. The little dog, his color was yellow, just like a grain of mustard, and he was very sharp. So, he was named as Mustard. But the dragon was a coward, and she called him Custard. Usually, a dragon is huge, it's fierce, it's so powerful, right? But in this poem, the dragon is, everyone thinks that the dragon is a coward. So she has not given him a very, dangerous kind of name which suits the dragon. Since he's a coward, she calls him Custard in a funny way. But was he really a coward? We'll find out. Custard the dragon had big sharp teeth. In this stanza, the poet is describing his physical appearance. The dragon had big sharp teeth and spikes on top of him and scales underneath. On his head, he had spikes, means sharp shapes, as you must have seen in the pictures of a dragon. And he had scales underneath. Scales means thick flakes of skin, which are there under the feet of dragon just to protect his feet. Mouth like a fireplace, chimney for a nose. His mouth was like a fireplace. When he was angry or something like that, he was so powerful that fire came out from his mouth. Chimney for a nose. His nose was like a chimney, and trilio trulio daggers on his toes. His nails, his toes were so sharp that the poet is comparing his toes with daggers, means knife. But this dragon wasn't fierce. He was very calm, composed and peaceful. Belinda was as brave as a barrel full of bears. Now in this stanza, the poet is talking about the other characters of the poem. So he says that Belinda was such a brave girl. She was as brave as a barrel full of bears. And Ink and Blink chased lions down the stairs. Ink and Blink were so powerful, or we can say they thought that they were so powerful that they could chase down the lions. Even lions were afraid of Ink and Blink. Mustard was as brave as a tiger in a rage. And Mustard, the dog, was so brave, he was just like a tiger. He was just like an angry tiger. But Custard cried for a nice, safe cage. Custard never fought with anyone. He never teased anyone. So he always wanted a nice, safe cage. He always wanted a peaceful and calm life. Belinda tickled him. She tickled him unmerciful. Since he was calm and peaceful, they thought he was coward. He didn't have any courage. So tickled means teased. Belinda teased Custard every day without any mercy. Ink, Blink and Mustard, they rudely called him Percival. They also used to make fun of Custard in a sarcastic way. They used to call him Percival. Who was Percival? Well, Percival was a knight. He was a soldier in King Arthur's army, and he was very strong. He was very powerful. He was very courageous. Since Custard is just the opposite of Percival, they used to sarcastically, just to make fun of him, they used to call him Percival. They all sat laughing in the little red wagon at the Trulio, Realio, Cowardly Dragon. So every day they would make fun of him all the time. They would call him a coward. Belinda giggled till she shook the house. Giggled means laughed. So the poet is saying that she made so much fun of the dragon that she laughed at him till she shook the house. This is just an exaggeration to show how much they laughed at him. They made fun of him. And Blink, said Vic, which is giggling for a mouse. Ink and Mustard rudely asked his age when Custard cried for a knife-safe cage. Ink and Mustard, they used to ask his age, that, oh, Custard, you've grown up so much. Still, you are such a coward. You do not have any power. You cannot fight with anyone. You are grown up and still you're just like a baby. But Custard never replied to them. He never fought with them. He never kicked them. He never hurt them. He always wanted a nice, safe cage. He always wanted a calm, a peaceful life. Suddenly, they heard a nasty sound and Mustard growled and they all looked around. One day when they were sitting, they heard a strange sound. Mustard growled and they all looked around. They all looked around to see who had come. Meow, cried Ink, and Ooh, cried Belinda. For there was a pirate climbing in the window. So in their house, a pirate had entered through the window. Window, again, poetic license has been used. It's a wrong spelling of window. Now, why would the poet use a wrong spelling? Like I said, just to create a rhyming effect. Belinda rhymes with window, right? So when they looked around, they saw a pirate, a criminal who had come to their house, who was climbing up the window to enter their house. Pistol in his left hand, pistol in his right, and he held in his teeth a cutlass bright. Cutlass means a short sword with a curved blade. So in this stanza, the poet is describing the pirate, that how dangerous he was. He had two pistols, one in each of his hands, and between his teeth, he was holding a sharp sword, a blade. His beard was black, one leg was wood. So he had black beard, he looked dangerous, and his one leg was wood, means he was crippled. It was clear that the pirate meant no good. So they understood that obviously he had come there to kill them. Belinda paled and she cried, help, help. Belinda, out of fear, she paled, means she turned yellow in color out of fear and she cried for help. But Mustard fled with a terrified yelp. Mustard ran away. Instead of fighting the pirate, instead of facing him, he just ran away because he was so terrified. Now, in the previous paragraph, The poet had described, he had portrayed them as so brave that they could fight anyone. But in this stanza, we come to know about their actual traits, that they were not brave. They only said, they only believed that they were brave, but in real, they were nothing like that. So Belinda turned yellow, Mustard fled, ink trickled down to the bottom of the household, and Little Mouse blinked strategically, Mousehold. So ink also ran away from the house, and Blink, since Blink was a mouse, so he went back to his hole. But up jumped Custard, snorting like an engine. Snorting means to make a sudden explosive sound through one's nose. So everyone was a coward. They used to tease Custard that he was a coward, but in real, they all were cowards. All of them ran away. Nobody could face the pirate. Nobody was ready to fight with him. Custard, who they used to teach, who they used to tease the whole time that he was a coward, he didn't have any power, he couldn't fight anyone. He was the one who faced the pirate. He jumped at him, snorting like an engine. And with all his power, all his might, clashed his tail like irons in a dungeon. And in rage, in anger, to threaten the pirate, he clashed his tail on the ground, just like irons in a dungeon. Dungeon means an underground prison. With a clatter and a clank and a jangling squirm, he went at the pirate like a robin at a worm. Robin is a bird. So with all his power, all his strength, he went at the pirate just like a robin attacks a little worm. The pirate gaped at Belinda's dragon. Gape means stared with mouth wide open. He couldn't believe that, you know, he would face such a creature. So he was amazed when he saw the dragon and gulped some grog from his pocket flagon. Gulped means he drank. Grog means a drink, alcoholic drink. Flagon means a flask. So he was carrying a drink in his pocket flask. When he saw the dragon, he was so afraid and he drank some of his drink, which he was carrying with him. He fired two bullets, but they didn't hit. To tackle Custard, he fired two bullets at him, but they did not hit. He missed his shots and Custard gobbled him every bit. Custard attacked at him. Gobbled means he ate him. He ate the pirate every last bit. Belinda embraced him. Mustard licked him. No one mourned for his pirate victim. So everyone, Belinda hugged the dragon. Mustard also licked him. Ink and Blink in glee did gyrate. Glee means happiness. Gyrate means dance. So Ink and Blink, they were so happy since the pirate was killed by Custard. They started dancing around the dragon that ate the pirate. But presently up spoke little dog Mustard. I would have been twice as brave if I hadn't been flustered. Flustered means confused. So in this paragraph, we come to know that the real nature of a person can never be changed. Although they were thankful that their lives were saved by Custard, but again, they are trying to defend themselves. They are not accepting their mistakes, that they were liars and they didn't have courage to face the pirate. Instead, they are defending themselves. So Mustard is saying that I am twice as brave and powerful as Custard, but I just got confused. Since the pirate came suddenly, so it didn't occur to me how to tackle him. And up spoke Ink and up spoke Blink. We'd have been three times as brave, we think. And Custard said, I quite agree. Ink and Blink, they also are saying that, yes, same thing happened to us. We would have been three times as brave as Custard. And Custard doesn't say anything. He says that, yes, I agree, because he doesn't want to waste his time explaining himself. So he says that, yes, I agree that you all are braver than me, that everybody is braver than me. Belinda still lives in her little white house with her little black kitten and her little gray mouse and her little yellow dog and her little red wagon and her realio trulio little pet dragon. So Belinda, she still lives in the same house with all of her pets, a kitten, a mouse, a dog, and a dragon, and she also has a wagon, a vehicle to travel. Belinda is as brave as a barrel full of bears. Now, this is the last stanza. Belinda is as brave as a barrel full of bears, and Ink and Blink chase lions down the stairs. Mustard is as brave as a tiger in a rage, but Custard keeps crying for a knife-safe cage. This paragraph shows that Belinda, Ink, Blink, Mustard, they still believe that they are courageous, they are powerful, and they are brave. We come to know that some people, they can never be changed, right? They can never accept themselves truly, and they still point out at the mistakes of other. They would keep passing comments at other people, but they would not see themselves for what they really are. So yeah, that's the poem is all about. Like I said, from this poem we get a message that we should not judge anyone from his or her appearance, because most of the times appearances are deceptive, and claims that people make to prove themselves, they are often false. So the true power, the true courage of a person can only be seen in, you know, difficult times, how a person reacts when he has a difficult situation in front of him. So yeah, that's what the poem is all about. Let's discuss the poetic devices now. In stanza 1 and 2, stanzas you can read on the right-hand side of your screen. First poetic device is alliteration. What is alliteration? Repetition of a consonant sound in close connection is called alliteration. See the underlined words. Lived in a little. Lived in a little. L sound is repeated here. Now the name of the little black kitten. Second paragraph, first line. Now the name. N sound is repeated. Second paragraph, second last line. Coward, and she called him Custard. Coward, called Custard. K sound is repeated here. So all these are examples of alliteration. We'll take two stanzas together. Next device is repetition. As you can see in both these stanzas, the word little has been repeated again and again. Little white house, little black kitten, little mouse, little yellow dog, little wagon, little dragon, right? So this is called repetition. Next is anaphora. What is anaphora? When two or more than two consecutive lines begin with the same word, it is called anaphora. As you can see in first stanza, third and fourth line, they start with the same word and a little yellow dog and a realio trulio. So this is anaphora. And similarly in second stanza, second and third line, they start with the same word and. This is also an example of anaphora. Next is simile. Simile means comparison. When a comparison is made between two things by using the words as or like, it is called simile. And when comparison is done without using the words as and like, it is called metaphor. So see the underlined words. And the little yellow dog was sharp as mustard. Here, yellow dog is compared to a grain of mustard, right? So it is called simile. And since the comparison has been done by using the word as, it is simile. Then we have poetic license. As I had already explained when I was explaining the paragraph, that when the poet takes the liberty to defy some rules of conventional language, conventional rules of language, it is called poetic license. So as we can see here, the poet has changed the spelling of really and truly. So it is poetic license. Let's move on to stanza third and fourth. First is alliteration. See the underlined words. Spike on top of him and scales. Spikes, scales. Sir sound is repeated here. Belinda was as brave as a barrel full of bears. Belinda, brave, barrel, bears. Burr sound is repeated here. And the last line, Custard cried for a nice, safe cage. Custard cried cage. Cur sound is repeated here. So all these are examples of alliteration. Next is poetic license. Again, same words, really, truly, instead of really and truly. Next is simile. See the third line of third paragraph, mouth like a fireplace. So here the poet is comparing the mouth of the dragon Custard with a fireplace. So it is simile. First line of fourth paragraph, Belinda was as brave as a barrel full of bears. Here the poet is comparing Belinda's bravery with that of bears. So since he's comparing Belinda's bravery with that of bears, it is simile. Similarly, Mustard was as brave as a tiger. Here, poet is comparing Mustard with a tiger. So this is also an example of simile. Next is metaphor. Like I said, when comparison is done indirectly without using the words like or as, it is called metaphor. See the underlined words in third stanza, third line. Chimney for a nose. Here, the poet is comparing Custard's nose with a chimney. So it is metaphor. Daggers on his toes. The poet is comparing his toes with knives, with daggers. So this is also an example of metaphor. Next is exaggeration. What is exaggeration? Exaggeration means a statement that makes something worse or better than it really is. Overstatement. Badha chadha ke describe karna is exaggeration. See the underlined words. Ink and Blink chased lions down the stairs. The poet says that Ink and Blink were so powerful that they could make lions run away. So this is exaggeration. This is an overstatement. So we call this device exaggeration. Moving on to stanza 5 and 6. First poetic device is repetition. As you can see in the first line of stanza 5, the word tickled has been repeated twice. Next is poetic license. Again, same words, realio, trulio. Next is alliteration. Third line of stanza 5. Laughing in the little red wagon. Laughing, little. L sound is repeated here. Stanza 6, first line. She shook the house. She shook. Sh sound is repeated here. And Blink said, Vic Witch is giggling. Vic Witch. V sound is repeated here. Ink and Mustard rudely asked his age. Asked age. A sound is repeated here. And Custard cried for a nice, safe cage. Custard cried cage. K sound is repeated here. So all these are examples of alliteration. See the second last line of stanza 6. Ink and Mustard rudely asked his age. Asked his age. This is not an example of alliteration. I have written it by mistake. Asked his age. A sound is not a consonant sound. It's a vowel sound, right? So, asked his age is not included in alliteration. Rest all are examples of alliteration. Next is exaggeration. Belinda giggled till she shook the house. Again, I have already explained what is exaggeration, which is a overstatement, right? So, Belinda giggled. She laughed so much. She laughed so hard that she shook the house. Now, literally, she did not shake the house. It is just exaggeration. Next is allusion. We have read about this poetic device in the poem Amanda also. If you have watched that video of the poem Amanda, in that poem, this poetic device has been used a couple of times. So what is allusion? Allusion means a brief reference of a historical or a mythical political, cultural figure, a thing, a person, or a place, anything of that sort is called allusion. So here, the poet has used Percival. He's used the reference of Percival, who was a knight in King Arthur's army. So this is called allusion. Moving on to stanza 7 and 8. First is repetition. As you can see in stanza 7, in the very first line, the word suddenly has been repeated twice. In stanza 8, in the first line, the word pistol has been repeated twice, and his has also been repeated twice. Next is alliteration. Suddenly, they heard a nasty sound. Suddenly, sound. Sir sound is repeated here. In stanza 8, second line, and he held his teeth. He held his. Her sound is repeated here. His beard was black. Beard, black. Bur sound is repeated. And the last line of stanza 8, it was clear that the pirate, that the sound is repeated. So all these are examples of alliteration. Next is poetic license. Last line of stanza 7. For there was a pirate climbing in the window. Now, the word is window, but the poet has changed the spelling of window to window just to create a rhyming effect, right? So this is called poetic license, when the poet uses a wrong spelling instead of the right spelling just to create a rhyming effect. Next is onomatopoeia. It is also called echoism. It means when words which represent some kind of sound are used. It is called echoism or onomatopoeia. Meow cried ink. Now the word meow represent the sound which is produced by a cat. Moving on to stanza 9 and 10. First device is repetition. As you can see in the very first line, the word help has been repeated twice. Next is simile. Simile means comparison by using the words as or like. See stanza 10. Custard snorting like an engine. Here, custard snort. His explosive sound has been compared with an engine. So it is simile. Custard his tail, clashed his tail like irons in a dungeon. So here, the smashing of his tail, the clashing of his tail on the ground is compared with irons in a prison. Iron chains in a prison. That he produced the same sound which is produced by the hitting of iron chains on a ground. So again, this is simile. Last line, he went at the pirate like a robin at a worm. Here, custard is compared with a bird, robin. So all these are examples of simile. We have alliteration. Last line of stanza 9. Mouse blinks strategically, mouse hold. Mer sound is repeated here. In stanza 10, third line, a clatter and a clank. Ker sound is repeated. So these are alliteration. Next is onomatopoeia. Like I discussed in the previous stanza also, it is also called echoism. When certain words which represent some kind of sound are used. Clatter and a clank and a jangling squirm. So all these words, they are used just to show the sound produced by the iron chains, the clattering sound. This device we had also done in another poem also, right? And more examples will come in next stanzas. Next is transferred epithet. See the second line, but mustard fled with a terrified yelp. The shout was not terrified. Who was terrified? Mustard was terrified. But instead of saying terrified mustard, the poet is saying terrified yelp. Right? Shout cannot be terrified. Mustard can be. So what is transferred epithet? When an adjective or a word is used with some other noun, and not with the noun which it is qualifying. So terrified actually qualifies mustard. It should have been used for mustard, but it has been used with the word yelp. It is called transferred epithet. Moving on to stanza 11 and 12. First is alliteration, gulped some grog. G sound is repeated. Then the second last line of stanza 12, gleeded gyrate. G sound is repeated here. So this is alliteration. Next is repetition. In stanza 12, line 1, the word him has been used twice. So it is repetition. Stanza 14, first line, Belinda still lives in her little white house. Lives, little. L sound is repeated, which is a consonant sound. So it is an example of alliteration. Next is repetition again. The word little has been repeated again and again. It is repetition. This paragraph has also been repeated. It was the same lines were used in first paragraph also, and now they have been repeated in stanza 14. So this is also a repetition. So in repetition, a word or a phrase, a sentence or a complete stanza can be repeated. Next is anaphora. As you can see, the last two lines, they start with the same word and her little yellow dog and her relio. So since these two lines, consecutive lines, begin with the same word and, it is called anaphora. Next is poetic license. Again, the same words, relio, trulio. Last paragraph, paragraph 15. Belinda is as brave as a barrel full of bears. Bur sound is repeated here, which is alliteration. Custard keeps crying for a nice safe cage. Custard crying cage. K sound is repeated here. Simile. Belinda is compared with bears and mustard is compared with tigers. And in both these lines, the comparison is done by using the word as. So it is simile. Exaggeration. And ink and blink chase lions down the stairs. So their power, their courage has been exaggerated, that they were so fierce and powerful that they could even make lions run away. Repetition. Like I said, this whole paragraph has been repeated. It is the same lines have been used which were used in stanza 2. So it is repetition. That's all about it. If you like the video, then please subscribe to my channel and hit the bell icon. Thank you.